So tell us, when did the email, or when was that sent to the district?
One of the school administrators received an email earlier in the day, and that was when we received notification of this threat that was received. So it was a threat that was received via email that had specific directions towards the two Nashua high schools with specific threats of violence, which is why we're taking it kind of seriously.
And why are all the schools affected, not just the two high schools, since those threats were made to the high schools?
Just the superintendent made the decision to close all the Nashua schools at that point. You know, we touched base with him with the information that we garnished during the day and throughout the investigation through the course of the day today. And with that information, he made the determination with his team to close the schools in Nashua for the day.
Lieutenant, talk to us about the fine line you face by giving someone attention. This is what they want. They get the whole system shut down.
Sure.
And obviously considering the possibility it could be real and somebody might want to do harm.
Yeah, it's definitely a tightrope. We have to keep in mind the safety of everybody involved, you know, students, teachers, other workers in the buildings. So it's a tough decision to make. You know, these seem to be going on throughout the country. They seem to be happening more frequently, and they are very disruptive on many different levels.
Can you talk about the threat just a little bit in terms of what it said in the email?
I'm not going to get into the specifics of the threat itself. You know, means or anything like that, other than it was specifically directed towards the two high schools in Nashua.
Are you confident it's credible?
That is under investigation right now. We're working with other state and federal law enforcement officials to try and determine the credibility of the threat.
Is the FBI involved?
The FBI is involved, yes. They've been assisting us.
And at this point, do you think, is it one person who made the threat, or is it a group?
We don't know.
Do you think it's the kid who wants to get out and do their homework or their midterms or finals this week?
Or maybe finish Christmas shopping. What do you think?
I would hope that it wouldn't be a student, but, you know, we don't have any information right now that says that it is, so we're looking at all angles.
How many schools total are shut down? So, because I thought it was just the two high schools, but it's not.
No, it's all the public schools in Nashua. We don't have any information right now that this affects any private school in Nashua. That we have a few private schools in Nashua. We don't have information
that... We have word that two of the private schools have closed as well.
Okay. They did that on their own accord then, but the threat that was received was directed towards the two high schools.
If this is a hoax, what kind of charges is the person who did this facing?
We'll get into that later. Right now we just want to take the investigation one day at a time and determine the credibility of it.
Are you close to an arrest? It doesn't really sound like it.
We have not made any arrests right now, no.
And when you look at the day you face tomorrow now, given that everyone's going to be out of school, what do you do police-wise in terms of, unsupervised kids now in your community? Nothing to do.
Well, you know, I'm sure that there's a lot to be done at home. I'm sure parents have a list of stuff that needs to get done before the holidays, and, the weather's supposed to be pretty decent, so I'm sure they'll be able to find something productive to do.
But you're not concerned that it creates then an issue that you have to deal with? Police, parents are working in a lot of cases.
It's not any different than any other school break or summer vacation, so.
Is there in common or anything, right? Because that parent out there was saying that it's like the second threat in like a month or something like that, she was saying.
Have you had other threats towards the school system?
I'm not aware of any other threat that has closed down schools for, you know, all the schools in Nashua.
Does this threat require any sort of sweep of schools?
That's definitely a possibility. You know, I mean, anytime you have a threat directed towards a school, it doesn't hurt to bring in additional resources as precautions. So
I guess we're just wondering, video-wise, just someone will be out there tomorrow morning at 7 a.m. with the mom sniffing dogs or anything like that, or they're out there now?
They could be out there now.
And real quick, the process right now is to go back with the IP address and stuff like that.
Yeah, we're going to work, with the FBI to try and backtrack some of the computer-related investigation angles and go take it from there.
As of right now, any idea where it could be coming from? Could it be like a Staples or, I don't know, like a random place?
We're still looking into that. Detectives are still looking into that as well.
Do you know how many kids are in the school system by any chance, a rough guesstimate?
No. You'd have to check with the superintendent would have all the stuff specific to schools and students and things like that. Okay?
Lieutenant, is there any...
Thank you.